The floor, well, the ground is like of dirt.
Mm-hmm. Are you indoors or outdoors?
Outdoors.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
It's kind of like I'm in town. Mm-hmm. I have the feeling like I'm over in Egypt or over in like a kind of like the desert area. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of construction, architect that's going on.
Tell me about this construction. What does it look like?
There's these type of sticks. Mm-hmm. They're kind of sort of like, so that the men can go up for height. Mm-hmm. These are these sticks that I see.
Mm-hmm. Can you see how these men are dressed?
These men are kind of like in cloths. Mm-hmm. It's like kind of like a offish white, like a tan color.
Mm-hmm. How big is this cloth? I mean, does it take the entire body?
There's kind of like their pants, mm-hmm, kind of tight at the ankle. Mm-hmm. And then there's kind of like cloth going across the chest, mm-hmm, area. I don't know. It also kind of makes me think that they have like, I think it's called like a tunic on their heads, mm-hmm, as well.
So they have some sort of a head covering also? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I want you to focus on yourself now. Look down at your feet. What do you see?
I see feet. Mm-hmm. Bare feet.
Tell me more. Are these male or female feet?
I feel like a male.
Mm-hmm. I want you to imagine in front of you a spiritual mirror where you can look into it. What do you see?
I see. I see a male who has like an important duty. Mm-hmm. A really important duty.
Mm-hmm. What do you do there?
Usually in the town, like in the marketplace. I don't know if I make bread. Mm-hmm. But there's like a lot, I can tell that there's a lot going on in the town. Mm-hmm. There's a lot just taking place, like I can feel the energy.
So let's go towards that town and see what it is that you do there. I want you to see yourself doing what it is that you do for a living. Where are you?
I'm still in the town area. It's kind of like a market. Mm-hmm. Market area.
What do you see yourself doing there?
I see myself it's, I want to say it's bread. It's some type of product or some type of goods that I'm providing to the people.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what that product is. I want you to focus on that. And you'll know it. What do you know this product to be?
It's food.
Mm-hmm. What's it made out of?
It's some type of like meat. Mm-hmm. Some type of meat.
Mm-hmm. Does it come from animals?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What animal do you imagine it to come from? What comes to mind? Trust your first impression.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's see what's happening in this scene. What's significant about this scene?
I'm at a place, I feel like I'm going to be called to do something
mm-hmm.
more than selling meat at the marketplace.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about this?
I feel kind of nervous.
Mm-hmm. Have you always been into this type of business?
Yeah, it's I had a family relative mm-hmm. help me get started.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like I'm supposed to be called to do more.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out what that is. I want you to advance that scene. Go ahead in time until you find out what it is that you've been called to do. See yourself there?
There's like an invasion. There's an invasion about to happen.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if it's like a war or something that's going on.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm supposed to I feel like called to help get everyone out, like, to safety.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens. See yourself doing that. Tell me what's happening.
A lot of people didn't believe me. A lot of people only looked at me as like the person who sold the meat mm-hmm. in the market.
Mm-hmm. Who charged you with this responsibility?
I feel like it was God.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like it was like just a sense of like knowing.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens. Take me through this time.
It's like I knew like that I had to help people. I had to, whatever invasion or whatever was about to take place, it was like I had to warn people. I had to warn them before it happened.
Mm-hmm. So how are you accomplishing this?
by trying to talk to as many people as possible.
Mm-hmm. What do they tell you?
A lot of people's it's looking at me like I have like two heads. Mm-hmm. They think I'm like crazy.
How do you feel when they say that to you?
A part of me, you know, it's like the weaker side of me, like, try to believe it, but it's like I know this feeling of knowing. Mm-hmm. I have to help these people.
Mm-hmm. Are you on your own, or do you have a family?
I'm on my own.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
I feel like maybe late 20s, mm-hmm. early 30s.
So you're still pretty young. Mm-hmm. You're not an elder. So they may not be taking you seriously. Mm-hmm. So what's happening now? I want you to advance that scene to see what happens.
So it's like now that I have a group of people.
Mm-hmm. How many?
That came, I want to say like 30 to 40 people. Mm-hmm. And it's not what I expected.
What do you mean by that?
I had the expectation of, you know, telling as many people as possible, but I only had like 30 or 40 people that came.
Mm-hmm. Have you taken these people to safety, or where are you?
We are actually traveling. Mm-hmm. I had the feeling that we had to leave. I had the feeling of knowing that we had to leave because something was going to happen. Mm-hmm. Some type of invasion. And now we're traveling. We're traveling to like safety, to another town. Mm-hmm.
Can you sense what's happening in your town?
I don't know if it's like a plague, mm-hmm. that's happening.
I want you to use all of your senses and just know what it is. What is it?
It's a plague. Mm-hmm.
So people are dying from being sick?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's like darkness was coming. Mm-hmm. Like there was no, even with the construction and stuff going on, there was still like a dark cloud coming over that town. Mm-hmm.
How do you feel now that you're going to safety?
I feel a lot better. Mm-hmm. I feel like I don't want to look back.
What about the people traveling with you?
These people, they trust me. I guess they might have felt the dark cloud too coming over this town. Mm-hmm.
What role do you play now with these people?
It's like I'm leading them in a sense, but it's like we can learn from each other. Mm-hmm. Because I'm still at a young age.
Yes.
So it's like we're all moving away to like safety.
Very good. Very good. So let's close that scene and now let's move ahead to another time in that same lifetime when something significant is happening. Where are you?
I'm settled into this new town. Mm-hmm. where it's a lot peaceful. The energy's like, I can't, the energy feels a lot different. I don't know. It's like we all started a new life.
Mm-hmm.
That's really peaceful, and we're all kind of like connected. We all are kind of connected in a sense.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
Really, really good, at ease.
Mm-hmm.
I just felt like we overcame a lot leaving that town and what was happening.
So how do you make a living now?
We're all, it's kind of like we all have a piece to the puzzle.
Mm-hmm.
It seems as though I still provide food. I go out to help find food for everyone. There's a lady that makes clothes.
Mm-hmm.
And there's another lady who helps, you know, with the children. So we all just, like, play a role.
Very good. Very nice community there.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So let's close that scene. Let's move ahead now to another significant event in that same lifetime. Moving ahead, getting the story. Where are you?
I'm still at the town. I'm mm-hmm. still there.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel older?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel now?
I want to say 50s.
Mm-hmm.
I have a wife. One of the ladies that came away from that town.
Mm-hmm.
We're married.
Anybody else in your family?
No kids.
Mm-hmm.
It's just me and my wife.
How is your life now?
Life is really good. You know, it's like I always think back though when I felt that call to leave that place. I always think, and my mind always goes back, like, what happened?
Mm-hmm.
But I just, I'm so happy and thankful for where I am now.
Mm-hmm.
And just,
it's a good life?
Yeah, it's a good life. Okay. Starting over.
Good. So let's move forward now. You're much older now. Where are you?
I'm laying down on a bed.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
I feel really old.
Mm-hmm. What's happening to you?
I feel like I'm tired.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm probably like 113.
Mm.
I feel really old.
Are you ready to let go of this life now?
Yes.
Very good. So what are the thoughts that are going through your mind before you transition?
Trust your instincts.
Trust your instincts.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Which you did.
Yeah.
Very good. Take your last breath now. Leave that body behind. And as you do, I want you to think back. See what the purpose was of that life. What did you come into that life for?
I came into that life to be in tune with my body.
Mm-hmm.
And be in tune with the energies.
Do you feel that you were successful at that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What lessons did you learn?
I learned to trust myself.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone won't always agree with you. Everyone won't always agree, but as long as you know your truth, that's all that really matters.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We can't change people.
Good. So let's continue on with your transition and tell me where you go to next. What happens after you leave that body? Where do you go?
Start a transition.
Mm-hmm. Where does your spirit, soul go?
It goes to the light.
Mm-hmm. What happens there? What are you experiencing?
I feel pressure in my chest.
Mm-hmm. What's going on with that pressure? Let's identify what that pressure is.
And then in my throat.
Mm-hmm. So let's identify what that is. Allow that pressure to speak. Allow it to come through and tell you what it is that it's experienced. I'm going to bring that pressure up, 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 and allow it to express itself. Good evening.
Hello.
What are you trying to tell me today? Who are you? What's your name? You can speak with me. You're safe. What do you want to tell me today?
Nothing.
How long have you been there in her chest?
For a while.
For a while. How did you find Aaron? What was going on that you found her? Mm-hmm. Well, it's a while since she was a child or recently?
A couple years ago.
Mm-hmm. What was she doing that made her vulnerable to you? What allowed you to attach to her? Were you sent to her?
No.
How did you find her then? Did she call you?
No.
Mm-hmm. Then what made you attach to her? Were you lost?
Mm-mm.
Well, you seem to be in a lot of pain. Why are you in so much pain? What happened to you when you had a body? Did someone do something to you?
That's my throat.
What did they do to your throat?
They hung me.
They hung you. What year is it for you?
1939.
And what did they call you at that time?
Jonathan.
Jonathan. Jonathan, what did you do to be hanged? Did you do something wrong? What did you do, Jonathan? Jonathan, I'm going to put my hand on your shoulder and you're going to feel just fine. You're going to feel just fine and be able to talk to me. Allow those feelings to subside. You'll be able to speak with me now. What's going on, Jonathan? Why were you hanged? Why were you hanged? Was it something you did?
Because I hurt people.
Mm-hmm. What did you hear? What did you hear, Jonathan? You can talk with me. There's no rope on your neck right now. What did you hear? You can tell me. I can keep secrets. The faster you tell me, the faster I can help you. Tell me all about it.
I hurt people.
Mm-hmm. What were they saying?
I didn't mean to.
You didn't mean to hear it?
I didn't mean to hurt people.
You hurt somebody?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What did you do? What did you do, Jonathan?
I killed someone.
Mm-hmm. Who was it?
It was a man. Mm-hmm. Who killed.
It was a man who killed?
A man that I killed.
A man that you killed. Who was he? Who was this man? Who's the man that you killed?
Killed them over money.
Uh-huh. Did you steal the money from them and kill them?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Did you act on your own accord or did someone tell you to do this?
Act on my own accord.
Uh-huh. So what did that money get you?
Death.
Death. Mm-hmm. Jonathan, can you forgive yourself for not knowing that this would be the results of that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You didn't know any better, did you? You were just acting out on something that you wanted.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't know that even though they hanged you, you still wouldn't be in peace. Right? How long have you been there with her?
For a while.
Mm-hmm. But you didn't tell me what was going on in her life that you took advantage of her. What was she doing at that time that made her so vulnerable to you?
She wasn't happy.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't have a voice.
That was the perfect person, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You didn't have a voice either.
Mm-mm.
They strangled you. So what have you been causing her all this time? How has she felt because of you?
Pain in her chest.
Mm-hmm. What is that pain in her chest caused by?
Anger.
Mm-hmm. What are you angry about, Jonathan?
The man, he owed me money.
Mm-hmm.
He owed me money.
What's his name?
Jim.
Mm-hmm. And who was Jim to you?
A man I did business with.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Like a partner.
Like a partner, and he owed you money.
Mm-hmm.
And you decided to kill him instead.
He owed me money.
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't paying me my money.
So what did that money get you?
Death.
Death. Is it worth it?
No.
How do you think Jim feels about him being killed by you?
I was stupid.
Mm-hmm. Let me talk to Jim now. 1, 2, and 3. Good evening, Jim.
Hello.
Do you realize that you've been killed by Jonathan?
Yes.
What happened to you after you died?
I knew I owed him money.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't think he would take my life mm-hmm. over money.
What happened to you? Did you go to the light? Or did you remain on this plane?
I went to the light.
Mm-hmm. So now, Jim, as you look at this miserable man who's been holding all of that anger, can you forgive him for what he did, not knowing that he would suffer so much?
Yes.
So go ahead and tell him how you feel about what he did to you.
I'm sorry that I couldn't pay you back. I had a lot of business that was failing. And I was just too ashamed and embarrassed to tell you. I didn't want to get over on you. I didn't think you would take my life away for it. But Jonathan, I forgive you.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk to Jonathan. Take a deep breath in. Jonathan, what do you feel now that Jim has told you this? How does that feel now? Now that you understand the circumstances.
I feel horrible. I feel wrong for what I've done.
Mm-hmm.
I thought he was trying to get over on me.
Mm-hmm. But he's forgiven you for that.
Mm-hmm.
Can you forgive yourself now for not knowing any better? For that misunderstanding?
Yes.
Allow that come out of you. I'm going to put my hand on your chest, Jonathan. I want you to unload all of that. All of that, all those feelings you've been holding all this time of being done wrong, of people betraying you, of being hanged for something as trivial as that, losing your life. Give me all of that. You don't need that anymore. Pull it out of every cell. Remove all of that pain. Physical, emotional, spiritual pain. Do I have it all? All right, let me take that. Let me take it and send it out to the universe now. Now, Jonathan, how would you like to feel instead?
I would like to feel at peace.
All right, so let's put some of that peace in there. Allow that peace to come in. Feel it coming in. And let's seal that. What else?
I would like to feel calm.
Mm-hmm.
Not in a rage.
Let's put all that calmness in there. We've taken that rage out already. Let's put that calm in and just seal that. What else?
And more understanding.
More understanding. Let's put that in there so you could understand. How does that feel now, Jonathan?
Can we put some love in your heart? Mm-hmm. Let's put love in your heart. Feel that love coming in from the Creator. Feel that light filling all of you. And let's that seal that. Now, Jonathan, I want you to focus on the part of your body that has been hurt.
Through.
Mm-hmm. I want you to go ahead and seal that. You can mend it now. Use your spiritual light to mend that part of your body. Use the light to put it back. Tell me everything you're doing, Jonathan.
I have this light going around my neck.
Mm-hmm.
Where they cut off my circulation.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I can breathe now. Mm-hmm.
So how does your chest feel now? Feels good, good. Right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. What would you like to tell Erin today about all of the discomfort you've made her feel?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry for causing you pain.
Mm-hmm. Take a deep breath in. Erin, what would you like to tell Jonathan?
It's okay.
Do you forgive him for not knowing any better?
Yes.
Let's send him to the light. I want you to, Jonathan, go inside of her body and pull out all of the influence that you've had on her. Go through her chest, through her neck, every part of her body. And I'm going to call in the angels of the white light. I'm going to have them surround you, Jonathan. Feel their love. Feel them surrounding you. Do you see them? Mm-hmm. How do they feel?
Lovely.
Very good. I'm going to ask Archangel Michael now to reach his hand out to you. Take you by the hand and take you directly to light. Back home. And tell me if there's anybody that greets you there.
No.
How does it feel?
Feels good.
Mm-hmm. So just allow your guide to help you now. Your guide is always there waiting for you. Allow your guide to greet you. May the light of the universe always accompany you, Jonathan. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. I know you could have shown Erin many different lifetimes today. Why did you show her what you showed her?
I need her to know that she can't change. She can't change people.
Mm-hmm.
She can't change people.
Who can she change?
Herself.
Mm-hmm.
That's why it's important to pay attention to how she feels.
Mm-hmm.
In her body.
It hasn't been feeling very good.
No.
Why is that? Besides Jonathan.
She's not eating the right foods.
Mm-hmm. What's she eating that she shouldn't eat?
I gotta use the bathroom.
All right. So we're gonna get back to the higher self in a moment. So I'm going to touch your shoulder, and when I touch your shoulder, that'll be the indication to open your eyes. You will remain in this beautiful state, and when we come back, we'll use the breath to bring you right back down, exactly the same place where you are now. Eyes open. Beautiful job. Be there now. Talking with a higher self. Thank you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. About what you showed her?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what's going on?
She needs to pay attention to her body and how she feels. She has been eating the wrong foods.
Tell her about that.
She seems like she's always hungry.
Yes, what's causing that hunger?
She's always hungry. She's like an emotional eater. So she's trying to, she feels like something is missing.
Yeah.
And she's eating a lot.
Well, she says that after she broke up with her last relationship, she started eating. What was that all about? Is it actual emotional, or did she attract something that's keeping her hungry?
It was more so emotional. She seems like she won't. She held so much emphasis on that relationship. It's like she doesn't. She kind of doesn't like believe in herself or trust herself.
So, what would you like to tell her about that?
That she needs to. She needs to get back in love with herself. And to trust herself and believe in herself. Once she gets back in a relationship and better herself, that eating to fill a void will, it will wipe away. She'll be fulfilled. She'll be filled on the inside. She don't need to stuff herself with food. She's just an emotional eater.
All right, so what can we begin today to start rewiring her so that she will feel more love for herself, so she doesn't feel the need to eat? I'd like to ask for maybe a guide who is a coach, a dietary coach for her that will guide her.
Okay.
So that when she goes to pick something that is not healthy for her, she'll get a reminder. What kind of reminder would you like to give her when she's not supposed to eat something?
She'll be more aware.
Okay, very good.
More aware.
She says that sometimes she's extremely happy, like ecstatic, and sometimes she's feeling really low, mad and frustrated at the world and how it's set up. How can she balance these extremes?
Eating a balanced diet. The foods that she eats, she's not healthy at all. So she's, her emotions are all out of whack sometimes.
So what would you recommend that she eat more of and less of?
A balanced diet. More of lively foods. Not the processed chunk that she's just been eating.
So tell her not to go through the center aisle of the supermarket. All right.
Stay with the nice colorful fruits and vegetables, lively foods. She'll start feeling better. Her emotions will be more balanced.
Very good. So really the major imbalance that she has right now is her diet. Is that something that really messes people up?
Everyone is different, but yes, she needs to be in tune with her body. She needs to be in tune with her body.
Is she exercising at all?
No.
So what would you recommend about that?
She needs to go running. She needs to do a lot of running, cardio. And that'll help too with her daily struggles, you know. She needs to run.
Very good. Now, I was told something a while back that when a person is involved with this metaphysical stuff and they start to channel, that they really need to get their body toned up. mm-hmm. because of the frequency that you're on.
Mm-hmm.
How would these workouts help her?
She would definitely be more lighter.
Mm-hmm.
Now she's like, she's a lot heavier, so it's dense.
Mm-hmm.
But the lighter you get, the more information that'll come to you. Like, she knows she received information a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she knows the different times she had information come to her. It's, you gotta have a balanced diet. And even honestly, she doesn't need to eat. She doesn't need to eat. If she fills herself up with self-love, true, unconditional self-love, and get to really embrace her all, mm-hmm. her whole self,
mm-hmm.
she wouldn't even need much food.
Mm-hmm. Very good. She says that she's had something in her right ear bothering her. It's like a strange whooshing sound. What is that?
It'll go away.
What is it? Is this an adjustment or something?
It's more, it's more so of a, like a reminder.
Mm-hmm. Who's whooshing in her ear? Is it anybody she knows? Mm-hmm. Well, maybe we can address that later. Mm-hmm. I'd like the archangels to call in whatever assistance that they have in order to identify what this whooshing is, if it's something beneficial or it's something that she shouldn't have, if they can identify that for her. I'd really appreciate it. She has questions about, some people have told her that she's been rooted or cursed since she was in her mother's womb. Where is that coming from?
There was a lot of negativity
mm-hmm.
towards her mother having a baby by a Caucasian man. There was a lot of, she wasn't necessarily cursed, but there was a lot of negative
mm-hmm.
thought forms surrounding her mom while she was pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
There was a lot of negativity.
How did that affect Aaron?
Some of the negativity came on to her mom
mm-hmm.
as well as Aaron.
So did she take that on as her own?
Somewhat.
Mm-hmm. So how is that affecting her today?
She's stronger than that though.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just really nothing she should worry about. She's stronger
mm-hmm.
than any negative force out there.
Can you look and see around her body if there's any negative forces that are trying to invade her space today? Okay, very good. So we don't have to worry about that anymore. Is that correct?
Yes.
All right, very good. Why isn't Erin consistent with anything in her life?
She hasn't really done anything that makes her happy.
Mm-hmm. She hasn't found her passion yet?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So what did you like to tell her about that?
She needs to keep doing the things that make her happy.
Mm-hmm.
The things that make her feel alive and her joy and she's smiling.
Mm-hmm.
She has to keep doing those things. It'll take her in the right direction, right where she needs to be.
What got her out of that path?
Being around the wrong people, and she's easily, I don't want to say easily influenced, but she definitely, she's sensitive to other people's energy.
Mm-hmm.
So, I kind of took her off the wrong path, being around other people.
Mm-hmm. So, what can keep her on her path? What do you recommend? She says she's distracted all the time.
Yeah, she has to get some solitude, be with herself.
Mm-hmm.
But not being with herself and just doing meaningless things. She has to, you know, do things that are going to benefit her. Like, she needs to go out running. She needs to, and it all comes back into being in a relationship with yourself.
Mm-hmm. So spend more time by yourself, exercise.
And bettering herself, yes.
Mm-hmm. And running is a form of meditation.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So maybe while she's running, she can actually get some downloads.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Very good. What is her purpose here? What is she supposed to be doing?
She's here to help.
Mm-hmm. In what way?
She's here to help people wake up.
Mm-hmm.
But not in a form of preaching or to try to convince.
Mm-hmm.
She's here to let people know that it's possible,
mm-hmm.
that it's to be happy and to be free.
Well, she had asked about she had two things that she was thinking about, that restaurant, visions of that restaurant. Is that something we were talking about?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What happened to that?
Yes.
How would that help people wake up?
Yes, that's providing proper nutrition.
Mm.
Proper nutrition. So what people need. I need her to still believe in it.
Mm-hmm.
She can't let that go. She has to still believe in that.
Mm-hmm. Well, last time she tried doing that, it was a bust. It didn't work.
Yeah.
Is she in the wrong place? Because, you know, location. Is she in the wrong place for that?
Yes.
Where should she be doing this? Just thinking of moving.
Yes, California.
Mm. She didn't really go with California when I brought that up.
Yeah. She's scared.
Mm-hmm.
I need her not to be scared. Just trust.
Mm-hmm. So she can open her restaurant in California?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Can I ask for a guide to help her with all of the financing and all of the ideas to help her launch this?
Yes.
Thank you. She's also thought of being of service to people, maybe becoming a channel or a QHHT practitioner. What are your thoughts on that?
Yes, she channeled before.
Mm-hmm.
Channeling is easy for her.
Mm-hmm.
To channel. It happens like naturally. She'll do good with that.
Mm-hmm. What about hypnosis?
Yes, she can do that if she will, if she wills.
If she wills it. Mm-hmm. Okay. But you also want her to do the restaurant. So it's up to her what she chooses.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good. She says that she's on a life path number 22.
Mm-hmm.
And she wants to know, she's very overwhelmed.
Yes.
Tell her about that.
She gets overwhelmed because she doesn't believe in herself.
Mm-hmm.
And it's definitely has to do with her weight right now and her self-esteem. But once she gets in shape and really start developing herself, she's going to be unstoppable.
Mm-hmm.
And she won't be overwhelmed by the things that she's supposed to be doing.
Mm-hmm. Which is helping people, awaken them.
Mm-hmm. But I mean on a large scale.
Mm-hmm.
And that overwhelms her. That large scale overwhelms her.
Well, we can only put one foot in front of the other, so... In doing anything, you just got to take a little bit at a time.
Mm-hmm. And work on the foundation first. That starts with our health.
Mm-hmm. So let's get moving on that health, moving on her exercising. Mm-hmm. And she could totally transform. Is this the reason why her visions have stopped, this weight?
Mm-hmm. The visions... And they also, it was because of the weight, but they also, it got to, I think, too strong for, in a sense, some of the stuff she's seen, it was like, she had, like, anxieties.
Okay.
From it too. So we shut it for now. But it once her health it gets better.
Okay.
It'll open back up.
Alright, so you'll reopen her eye once she gets back into shape.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good. She says that she wants to live her truth. She wants to know who she is 365 days a year. Not this up and down stuff.
Yeah.
Is that possible? Kind of tough doing that on the earth.
It is in a sense, but she does need to live her truth.
Mm-hmm. So define to her what her truth is.
Her truth is that she's love. That's who she is. Regardless of what goes on outside her, or what the world tries to tell her, she has to know from within that she is love. That is the truth of who she is.
Now when she's interacting with people who she works with, people who she loves with, relationships.
Mm-hmm.
How could she maintain that? Because at this time, her family is not in a very functional, don't have a very functional relationship there. How can she maintain living her truth in this dysfunction.
She has to accept how things are. Accept them the way they are, because she can't change people.
Mm-hmm.
So she will be moving soon. She won't be there.
Okay.
Won't be there long, but until then, just focus. She has to focus on herself.
Okay.
And love herself.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, be example. That's the best way to teach anybody, is to be example and to demonstrate. If she wants to really help, especially her family,
mm-hmm.
just be an example.
Good. She also told me that she wants to develop her omnipotence and her
omnipresence.
Thank yes. you for that.
Yes.
How can we do that?
That takes time.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a lot of time. She just has to be focused on developing herself.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. She's had some visions, or some dreams, of the blue king-like man
mm-hmm.
who said, "Your dream world is my world." Mm-hmm. Where'd she go? Who is this blue man?
That's her twin flame.
Mm. Where is he?
He's waiting.
Mm-hmm.
He's waiting for her.
Now, is this blue man somewhere here on Earth?
No.
So how can he be waiting for her? Is she going to meet someone that fulfills her in this lifetime?
Yes.
Okay.
She will.
Mm-hmm. It won't be her twin flame.
No.
But it'll be someone that she could love.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Will she be finding this twin flame in California?
Possibly.
Mm-hmm. It's someone possibly. New?
Yes, possibly.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So fill her with that love that she will feel when she meets this person. So she'll know how to recognize him. It'll match her frequency.
Yes.
Very good. What were the Anunnaki trying to tell her in her dream? They had glowing eyes.
They were actually checking in on her.
Mm-hmm. What's going on?
Nothing to worry about.
Mm-hmm.
But they were just checking in on her.
What does she have to do with the Anunnaki?
That's where she comes from.
Mm.
That's her lineage.
Okay. Is that where she gets her power?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what is she supposed to be doing?
She's supposed to be helping.
Mm-hmm.
She's supposed to be helping a lot of people.
Mm-hmm. At this time?
Mm-hmm. That's why she gets overwhelmed. by the responsibility. She gets overwhelmed by it.
What is she supposed to be doing with this knowledge of metaphysics?
It's more so for her to develop herself. Mm-hmm. So she can be an example.
Okay.
And once she becomes fully developed, that's when she can give the knowledge to other people, but only if they seek it. She doesn't need to convince anyone.
Mm-hmm. Just be an example of what it is?
Yes.
Okay, good. Why did she choose her family? It seems to be some people that she doesn't get along with. Why them? Just not close to them. She doesn't even look like them. What's that all about? Was that intentional? To be the white sheep?
She always feels alone in her family.
Yeah.
But we're trying to show her it's okay. It's okay. It's all right. That's what comes with loving yourself. Even if you can't receive the love from the outside, you have to be able to fill your own cup. So it's okay.
Isn't one's own family kind of a reflection of the family of life?
Yes.
So if she feels alone in her family, she may feel alone in the world.
It's okay.
Just love yourself.
It's okay to be alone. She's has to do work of service.
Okay. Good.
It's okay.
I can give her lots of tips about how to be alone. And enjoy every minute of it. Does she have any karmic contracts that she needs to break?
Yes. Yes.
With her relationships? Can we do that today?
Yes.
All right. Would you allow me to do this exercise with her?
Yes.
All right. Very good. So, Aaron, I'd like for you to imagine yourself standing in front of this person that you need to break this contract with. Both of you have a contract. And I want you to say to him out loud, "We tried, we've really tried.
We tried. We really tried.
But it's not working.
But it's not working.
You go your way with love.
You go your way with love.
And I'll go my way.
And I will go my way.
We don't need to be together anymore.
We don't need to be together anymore.
Now I want you to envision yourself and him breaking the contracts that you've made to be together. You can tear it up. You could burn it. You could stomp on it. You could blow away the ashes. And I want you to see what happens now.
She's free.
Very good. Thank you very much. Is there anyone she needs to break the contract with? Any others?
No.
Very good. What is it that happened in 2012 with the metaphysics?
That's when she had her awakening.
Anything else you would like to tell her about that?
She knows. She knows. That's when she woke up. I knew there was more.
Even though she's woken up and she's got all of this under control, why is it that she gets this nervous laugh? What's causing that laugh? Is that coming from herself, or is it coming from an influence? Who's sabotaging those times?
It's coming from an influence.
Where is this influence?
In her head.
In her head. All right. Would you permit me to speak with it today? All right. Let me bring that down, 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 down. Good evening. Are you male or female energy?
Male.
Male. What's your name?
What do you call yourself?
Don't have a name.
You don't have a name. Who created you?
Did you ever have a body?
No.
So something must have created you. Did Aaron create you, or did somebody else?
She created me.
And why did she create you? What was the purpose of it?
Negative thought forms.
So what is it that you do for Aaron since she created and birthed you?
Give her negative thoughts.
So you kind of feed her with that? What else do you do?
Yeah, like try to scare her.
What else?
Feed her negative thoughts, I scare her.
Do you have anything to do with her laughing in inappropriate places? Why do you do that?
That's my job.
What is your job?
To scare.
So when she laughs inappropriately, it scares her, huh? It
makes her feel uncomfortable and she's embarrassed.
So let me speak with Aaron now. Aaron, do you realize that you've created a thought form on your own? What would you like to tell this thought form?
I don't need you anymore. You have to go.
But Aaron, you see, you created this thought form. It's part of you. You birthed it. And it's a part of you. You can't make it go away. It's not like something that isn't part of you. You created this thought form to do something for you. It's like you gave it birth. What would you like this thought form to do now? Because you can't just tell part of you to go away. You have to give it another job. What would you like this thought, this entity that you've created, to do for you now?
I would like for you to motivate me and encourage me and not try to make me feel little about myself.
All right, let's see what it says. What do you think about that?
I can do that.
Mm-hmm. So tell Erin how you're going to motivate her. What's the best that you can do for her?
I can motivate. I can encourage. And I'll give her tough love.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's speak with Erin.
Erin, do you realize that when you create a thought form that's part of you, you're like its goddess?
Okay.
And so I want you to go ahead and send that energy, lots of love. All that love from your heart, I want you to send it up to your head. Understand that this is part of you that you created. And just like you created all this negativity with all of this passion, all of this energy, I want you to use now all of that passion and energy towards changing it, restructuring it into total love, total motivation, working towards your highest good. Go ahead and send it that command. Tell me when you've completed it.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Let me speak with the higher self now.
Yes.
What do you think about that now?
That's good.
Mm-hmm. So now she doesn't need to be embarrassed in situations like that?
No.
Mm-hmm. She'll be motivated. She'll have all of the right information.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Can you do a body scan on her and see if there's anything that we need to take care of physically today?
She's good.
She's good to go. All right, if I would please have the archangels and the angels of the light come in and seal her aura, fill her with complete light, like the higher self, to please direct the angels to any place that she needs additional sealing today, so that when she leaves here without any entities or any influence, that she is kept protected. Fill her with that love. Seal her aura. Align her chakras. And look through her body to see if there's any implants or anything like that that needs tending to today. And let me know when you're done.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Good to go. Is there anything that I could have asked that I didn't ask that you would like to tell her now? A message for her?
No.
We're good. Thank you very much for all the information you've given her today. I know she's really going to appreciate it. Eyes open, wide awake. Hi.
Hello.
How do you feel?
Good.
Yeah?
Yeah, so good.
What do you think about this whole process? Now that you've been through it.
Yeah, it was... It was a lot. Actually, it was a lot.
You sound almost giddy. Like, yeah. You're trying not to.
I know. Like, I'm so excited. The information I've received.
Mm-hmm. Were you receiving more information than what you were saying?
I know.
Mm-hmm. It seemed like that.
Yeah, it was like...
You were wide open. How long do you feel you were on this journey? Really feel?
Like 40 minutes.
Like an hour and a half.
Hour and a half.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Pretty good. What impacted you the most?
What impacted me? It was more the feeling of when I let myself down.
Mm-hmm.
want to let myself go, and I stopped loving myself. Because you can see how, like, things happen.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
And your higher self wants you running and eating well and really getting back into shape.
Yeah. And it's like, seeing like that, then everything else will start to fall into place, too. Mm-hmm. So, like, your health is really important.
It is important. Yeah. It is important. When I started doing this work, I was told by several different channels that I needed to work out. I needed to be in very good health.
Yeah.
Because the information I'm channeling is very strong for my body. And I need to be fit in order for me to do this.
Yeah.
So it's very important for me to eat well and to always exercise, because the energy is just too strong for me to handle if I'm in bad health.
I know. And in the past life, when I was the man and my body was nice, and it was weird because it was like, it was like real nice as a man. It's like, he's fine.
So now you've been there.
Yeah.
So now that you've had this experience, and I know that you found me through YouTube, is this something that you feel that you want to share, or do you feel that it's personal and you don't want to share? It's up to you.
I can share it. I can share it.
It's up to you.
Yeah, I would just want to block out two things.
Yeah, and we could talk about that. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I edit my stuff, so.
All right.
It's nobody's business.
Yeah, other than that, was good.
Sounds good?
Yeah.
Great, so let me disconnect you, and we're going to sit up and say goodbye to everybody. All right, so here we are. Good.
Yes, really
all
good.
Right, so tell everybody what you felt from this.
This experience was really good. It's a lot of the information. It was like I needed to hear it.
Yeah.
It was like, it's like you know it, but it was like, all right. It's like now it's right in your face. Like you need to hear it.
And you are already a channel. I mean, you pick up a lot of stuff already. So how did it feel to be in hypnosis for you? What was the experience like for you?
It was easy. I felt like, I really felt like it was easy. Like when I went to the bathroom, I was like, whoa. I was like, I am floating. I felt like I went pretty easy.
Yeah. And you saw things clearly?
Yes. A lot of it was clear.
How does it feel to speak through your higher self? How did that feel for you?
It sounded like just a better version of me. It felt like a more smart, wiser version of me.
Yeah. So when you heard it, did it feel loving? I mean, did it feel authoritative or what?
Authoritative. Yeah.
Like kind of like get your act together type of thing. Like, you better start running. Yeah. We want to see you running.
Yeah. As I said, I'm like looking forward to embrace all of this.
Excellent. All right, so you recommend this to others?
Yes.
What would you say to people to prepare them for this experience? Because, you know, it took you a long time to get here. You made this appointment months ago. How would you prepare for something like this?
Really don't have expectation. Really don't have expectation, like you said. And really go with inside of yourself, like really go with outside of yourself and like kind of stay centered and really, you know, find out the questions. What's your purpose for coming here? What's your really reason?
Your intention.
Yeah.
You can't just come out of curiosity.
Yeah.
I always tell people when you get in your car, you just don't sit there. You have an intention to go someplace. So when you come here, you should have an intention as to what it is that you're coming here for. Not just, I'm just curious. Yeah. Really, because your higher self is here to answer questions. So you need to at least get your mind as to where it's like a compass. You have to, it's going to point you in that direction.
Yeah.
Good?
Yeah.
So where are you coming from? Where did you come from?
South New Jersey.
South New Jersey.
Yeah.
Yeah. I grew up in Northern New Jersey.
Yeah.
So we don't see
it. I was about to say two different worlds.
Two different worlds. Two totally different worlds. Especially now, it's nothing like when I grew up. Yeah. But anyway, so we came from the same area. So if you want a session with me, you can go to my website, albaweinman.com. And just select the date that's most convenient for you and
we'll see you sometime in the future. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.
See ya.
Best part, the hug. Right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. It was great.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.